What is going on, YouTube? Welcome back to another video on the channel. And today, guys, we are back on Basketball Arena. And today, we're going to go ahead and do a guide for you guys. The best tips and tricks, in my opinion, that I've kind of gone through for the first day of playing the game. And this game is actually extremely fun. If you guys have not downloaded it yet, make sure you guys go ahead, download it, give it a shot. Very fun game. There is a $50,000 event going on right now, which a lot of people are downloading for this event, which I'm going to go ahead now. And we're going to start explaining some key tips on how you guys can actually get very close to winning this tournament if you guys are pretty much motivated to win in it. And it's not even that hard, in my opinion, to get onto the top 10 place, which is only 60 wins in a row, I think, right? 64. So, like I said, we're going to go over some tips on how you guys can win games and everything. Before we go ahead and hop into that, make sure you guys drop your like, subscribe if you guys want more content like this. Also, memberships are actually back on the channel, so if you guys want to join as a member, the link is in the description. And if you guys do join as a member, you guys can go ahead on Instagram and send me a picture, actually, of anything, and I'm gonna make sure one of the membership emojis things is actually whatever you send me, whatever image you send me. So if you want a picture of, like, whatever, I'll just put it as one of the membership emojis. So go ahead, join it, and then send me your Instagram at. But let's go ahead and hop right into the thing, the gist of this now. When I was playing my first day, I noticed a lot of times when I was playing the game in general is you're going to run into people that spam abilities, which if you guys don't know what the power-ups are or the abilities, there's a bunch of these ones. We're going to go over what ones you guys should use, what ones you guys just kind of stay away from. The key thing I would say into playing this game, if you guys want to win games, you guys have to use your powers. You'll notice when you guys first go against kids, they're going to spam you with every power-up they have. The best counters to all of them we're going to go over, which is the first one, which is the best power-up in my opinion in the game, is the ice one right here. It pretty much freezes your opponent, and they're stuck in a little ice thing, and they can't get out unless they break out, which you get pretty much a free shot off of it. Which, if you guys do use this in the proper way, which the best proper way, in my opinion, of using the freeze is making sure you guys take a three-pointer. Okay, take the three-pointer. Do not freeze them and then go for two. That's a waste. Wait for the perfect moment. Like, say you get the ball back, freeze them instantly, take a three, and make sure you guys, of course, have enough stamina to make the three, which we're going to go ahead and get some gameplay after this, and I'll show you guys how I play and how my motto is a little bit. Another good power-up that I use is this one right here, is like the distortion kind of, or I call it distortion. It kind of like messes with their player, so they walk backwards and all that. This is a good thing to use, again, for taking threes. I use it for taking threes, especially when I'm down. Say I have the ball, I've just put the disorienting on, and it pushes them backwards, and it kind of pisses the opponent off, of course. And of course, it pisses me off too sometimes. Go ahead, take a free three off of that. I would say these are the two best power-ups to start with. You guys could also unlock more power-ups and use more at the same time. I also use the giant player, which is not a bad one, but there's also a lot of there's a bomb add-on time one, which I don't use the time one just because, I don't know. Think about it. If you're adding time, it could help you, but at the same time, it could kind of cuck you at the end of it. But that's it for the power-ups here. Let's go to the team now, the little guide right here for the team. It doesn't matter who you use, in my opinion. If you guys have noticed, like, their stats for the players, you know what I noticed, if you guys don't have James Harden, dude, I'm just saying, this card's very good. I think it's like 99 cents right now, which is extremely cheap. This is the best card to get, in my opinion, right now, for very cheap, and just to use. And he's just very good overall. And another person that I think is really underrated is Tadaya, and I use her a lot as well, which I got her right off the start of the game. She's very good. Make sure you guys use her. She's really good for stealing the ball instantly, taking the ball away, and all of that. So if you guys do start the game, I would say start off by using Tadaya. You also get to start with the blue hair guy, which I call Ninja. Ronnie, he's not bad as well of a good start. But if you guys want to have a good start to the tournament, by the way, for the Mr. Beast 50K, or not just the tournament in general, I would say when you guys first start the game, make sure you guys do not lose your streak. Because if you guys start to level up in the game, right now, I'm a level 20 now. So I'm going to be going against level 20s now for the rest of my time playing the game. So now I'm going against a lot better players, you know what I mean? So if you start the game at level 1 and you keep leveling up, like keep winning games against this, like level 2s and 3s, trust me, you're going to be able to win, which that was the biggest mistake I made, which I wish I can restart my account right now and go from level 1 and just start from there, because if I didn't fail, I probably could have been at like a 50 win streak now. So that's the big thing, is like, if you guys are just starting the game, make sure you guys do not lose your streak off the beginning, because you guys can easily win this tournament if you don't, like I said, don't level up as fast. Let's go ahead and hop in some gameplay here. We went over the team, the power-ups, and also a couple things to counter the power-ups. Ice One is when you guys are going against the Ice One, you guys can actually break out of it by clicking the punch feature, which is like the throw feature, so make sure you click that. Let's go ahead and hop into some gameplay and show you guys what it's all about in terms of winning games and what I do to win games and what I think is the best thing to do. So the dash ability, which I think is the most important thing you guys have to use. I love this ability because you're able to dash, steal the ball, but you're right here, watch. So when someone comes at me, I just go right past it with a dash, go right for the dunk. So the best thing is when you guys first have the ball, I would say wait a couple seconds, wait for them to come towards you, and then dash. So watch, we'll do it again. We're gonna dash right past him right there, and we're gonna go ahead and get the layup. So we're gonna make sure we don't lose against this kid. You can see he's using his abilities, which this one's the invisible one, which is very hard to counter, which I did counter. And you can see he also used his other ability, which is the bomb one, which basically kind of cucks him. Look, he's using all these abilities. Like I said, you're gonna go against guys that spam abilities. It's very annoying, I know. I know the thin actually disconnected, so let me fix this real quick. Hopefully I don't lose because of this. That would kind of suck. I don't know why the thin disconnected, but we're good. We're back in the game. But yeah, like I said, you're going to go against a lot of spammers that spam abilities. It's annoying, but guess what? You can outsmart them and win either way. I usually win without using abilities because I just outplay the people. Right there, he got a lucky one ball. Let's go ahead and dash right past this guy again. Go for the two. And I'm going to go ahead and use the distortion thing in a second here and show you guys how it's used. So you can see I'm gonna push him back, I'm gonna steal the ball, and I'm gonna go ahead and just dunk on him. And he's gonna go ahead and take a three. He's got no power, and I'm actually gonna take a three from here. You can see he's really far back. I say take those threes if you guys know you guys can make the shot. Don't just take it randomly, but you can see he has no power right now, so he's not gonna be able to jump anymore, see? So I can take another three right there. He's wasting his power. This kid, I feel like this kid's a beginner, or not a beginner, but just hasn't played the game in a while, because you can see he's trying to take threes with like one power bar. I don't know what this kid's doing, but you can see again another three. Tadaya, like I said, Tadaya's very good when it comes to stealing, and just she's really good at everything. One tip is when you guys first start, dash and steal the ball off of them. This is the biggest thing I think I do, and it's so easy to finesse the ball from them when you first start. When they first have it, I don't know, how did I make that? When it first starts, when they have it in the hand, dash towards them, hit the ball out, and just go for the dunk. It's so easy, especially if they try to take a three. You could literally just finesse it from their hands, which is really good. But that's going to wrap it up, guys, for this guide. If you guys have any questions, comment down below. If you guys have any other tips, basically, that you guys want everyone else to know, make sure you guys comment down below. Also, comment down your biggest streak, dude. I want to see how far you guys got in. My biggest streak, I think, is 33. Which I'm trying, dude, I want to get to 70 streak, dude. That would be insane if I can get to 70 streak. Like I said, make sure you guys drop a like, subscribe if you guys are new. We'll scale about 20 likes in this video, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace out, guys.